Cuando el caos choca en espacios reducidos, se desarrollan dramas inesperados a cada paso.
Oh, get it. Get downstairs, lady. Get downstairs.
I can't carry it.
No, get your
Desde borrachas peleonas hasta audaces intentos de abordaje, estos cuatro incidentes muestran el drama inesperado que puede estallar en los límites de un aeropuerto.
I had two whiskey sours.
Whiskey sours?
Yeah.
Just two?
Yeah.
Okay, have you got your driver's license?
Comencemos nuestro primer incidente con Laura, quien provocó una escena en el aeropuerto de Texas el 17 de marzo de 2023, justo después de encontrarse ebria en una pelea con la ley.
Hold on just a second. Hold on.
Okay.
What's going on? Hey.
What are you doing up?
What's going on? Huh? Can you talk to me? Can you talk to me? What's going on?
Something. Huh? I don't know where I'm going.
Wait a second. What's going on?
It's a mobile.
Huh?
It's just to go to Mobile, Alabama.
Okay, Mobile, Alabama?
Yeah.
Okay. So why didn't you go to Mobile?
A flight's leaving in a minute.
Huh?
Do you have a panic attack or something?
Yeah.
Probably, just go ahead and
panic. It's a minute. It's leaving.
Okay, slurred speech.
It's leaving.
Cuando los agentes se acercaron a la mujer, ella estaba muy agitada, afirmaba no saber dónde estaba y lloraba. Los oficiales intentaron comprender la situación y dialogaron con ella para evaluar la necesidad de arrestarla. El comportamiento de la mujer se intensificó, dando lugar a un encuentro tenso.
Okay. Hey, answer my question. Have you had something to drink today?
Yeah.
Alcoholic beverages?
Yeah.
Where at?
Just in the bar.
This bar right over here?
Yeah.
How many did you have?
Two.
You had two drinks?
Yeah.
What kind? Remember?
I had two whiskey sours. Yeah.
Just two?
Yeah.
Okay, have you got your driver's license?
Did you see what happened?
Do you have your driver's license?
Yeah.
Look in your wallet, okay?
Where is?
Well, look in your wallet. It's got to be in your bag somewhere.
Los oficiales le preguntaron sobre su consumo de alcohol y esta reveló información contradictoria sobre la cantidad de tragos que tomó. La conversación con la sospechosa se volvió inconexa. Y ella mencionó un ataque de pánico y una partida inminente a Mobile, Alabama.
Okay, your wallet's right there.
It's in her purse. I just put her license in her purse.
In her purse?
Yes.
Her purse?
Yes.
Look in your purse.
No, it was a black purse.
There's a black purse.
Yeah, yes. It's in there.
Look in there. Look in your purse. That's where it's at.
See it right there.
See it right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Grab it. See it. It's flipping around in there.
Right
there. You got your hand on it.
Yeah.
Thank you. Can you get your boarding pass for me? Your boarding pass is in that right there. Can you find that? Okay. Thank you. All right.
So why are we striking the gate agent over here?
Yes. Why are we trying to punch him? No, I don't.
Did you hit the gate agent?
No, I didn't hit him.
Huh?
I didn't hit him.
You didn't touch him?
No.
Hey, so this is Officer Lambert there at DFW Airport Police Department. Okay. We're out with, I'm guessing it's your mother right now. This is Laura.
Samuel Allen.
So she is severely intoxicated right now, and she did try to strike the American Airlines gate attendant a couple times. So I'm just going to kind of be blunt with you. She's probably going to be coming with us for public intoxication. So she's going to be going to jail for a little bit until she sobers up. That is correct.
957.
What?
pretty much until she sobers up and we deem her that she's all right to take care of herself. And it's basically on the same line as a speeding ticket, but the reason that she's going in handcuffs is because she's got to be under our watch and care so she doesn't harm herself or anyone else. It's going to be around like a $300 ticket essentially, but...
Cuando los oficiales intentaron recuperar su identificación de su bolso, la mujer se angustiaba cada vez más, expresaba confusión y se resistía a cooperar. Mientras tanto, antes de tomar la decisión de arrestarla, los agentes llamaron a los médicos. Los médicos tomaron sus signos vitales, asegurando su bienestar antes de que fuera arrestada.
Hey Laura, can you stand up for me? You need some help? Here.
Turn around close.
Go ahead and turn around for me. Go. You're being placed under arrest for public intoxication. Okay.
Okay. Hold up. What are we doing?
Come on. Stand up for me. Come on.
I got the other one.
All right. Back up.
So you don't fall out.
Oh my God.
Stop.
Stop now.
Hey, relax. Relax, okay?
If you kick one of us, you're going to be going to jail.
I didn't kick nobody.
Well, don't try to kick. All right, I need you to sit up in the chair. Come on.
Los agentes decidieron arrestar a la mujer por estar borracha en público, lo que empeoró aún más las cosas. La sospechosa se resistió violentamente al arresto y los policías tuvieron que llevarla en silla de ruedas. Incluso un agente le sujetó las piernas porque se resistía con mucha fuerza.
Brush up and down, okay?
Okay?
I got a camera. He's got a camera. Partner over here has a camera. File. You turn on your front camera. File. Yeah, on camera. Okay, got a car camera going too. Okay, I'm gonna use the back of my hand, all right? Let's walk over here to the left. Top of that car, right?
No! There's no reason for you to take me all the way back to Florida for no reason! For no reason!
Mientras la sacaban del recinto del aeropuerto, siguió pateando a los agentes. Incluso después de que la subieron al auto, siguió gritando, resistiéndose y tratando de quitarse el cinturón de seguridad. La sospechosa enfrentó consecuencias legales por sus acciones, acusada de resistirse al arresto sin violación e intoxicación pública. Ahora que hemos sido testigos de la caótica escena con Laura, profundicemos en otro incidente aeroportuario que nos lleva a un viaje salvaje que involucra el perturbador intento de una mujer enojada de abordar un avión. En este incidente, un vuelo de rutina a Detroit, Michigan, dio un giro extraño cuando una mujer rebelde con antecedentes de agresión intentó abordar tarde, lo que provocó una cadena de eventos caóticos.
I'm sorry, I just walked in. Like you guys, I walked in with you guys. For what I understood, I just rushed in. The agent went to close the door, and there was one that was sitting on the flight and was refusing even to move. Philippe, is Stephanie inside?
They said that already?
I was doing
G14. She's inside. She's inside?
She's inside the plane. Let me just go in.
Because there was one that was refusing getting out.
El disturbio estalló el 10 de julio de 2022. Después de finalizar el proceso de embarque para el vuelo a Detroit, el personal de vuelo notó que esta mujer intentaba abordar 45 minutos después del despegue. Empujó a los asistentes de vuelo, saltó sobre los pasajeros e insistió en reclamar su asiento. La azafata, al darse cuenta de la gravedad de la situación, llamó rápidamente a un supervisor. La sospechosa amenazó con agredir si el avión no despegaba. Los oficiales fueron alertados, y lo que sucedió después fue una locura. La mujer, desafiante e inflexible, se negó a obedecer. Ella argumentó que pagó su boleto como todos los demás y no debería ser señalada. La loca se resistió a cooperar a pesar de las instrucciones del oficial de trasladar la conversación afuera para una discusión más privada. Ella se negó a interactuar con las autoridades en la pista y solicitó la documentación por correo. Este desafío complicó y mucho los acontecimientos. En un intento por calmar la situación, los agentes solicitaron a todos que desembarcaran y siguieran los protocolos. La sospechosa, sin embargo, no cooperó, expresó frustración y acusó a los agentes de hacerle la vida imposible.
Let's go. You go in front of me.
And she gonna go behind me. And she's going behind me.
No, okay. I don't mind, all right. Clearly.
All right, let's go.
You're not going go behind me, though.
Ma'am, let's go.
You can go, and I will go behind you.
Go ahead.
You're not walking behind me, period.
Ma'am, let's go.
I don't trust you. I don't trust. Yes, please record. Thank you.
I give you this.
My Instagram is. So send it to me so I can send it to my daddy. I show only bag. Because they're definitely not walking behind me. Because, yeah, make sure y'all Instagram, Skype. Send me videos so I can send it to my dad. They already have my ID. I got on the plane.
We need your ID.
Don't make it worse.
They're making it worse for them. That's illegal as f. I didn't do shit. I have a ticket like everybody else.
Everybody here is out. And
I have a ticket like everybody else. What do you mean?
A pesar de los intentos de razonar con la sospechosa, ella continuó resistiéndose, manteniendo su postura de que no hizo nada malo. Tenía un boleto válido y luego abandonó lentamente el avión. Al abandonar el avión, la sospechosa declaró rotundamente su inocencia y se negó a cumplir las instrucciones de los agentes. Ella cuestionó la legitimidad de su arresto, argumentando que su billete le otorgaba el derecho a permanecer en el vuelo como a todos los demás. Sin embargo, la situación tomó luego otra dirección.
I'm relaxed. You're grabbing me. What do you mean?
Relax.
Because why is he grabbing me and I'm relaxed? Like I said, he grabbing me. It's illegal as fuck, though. It's cool because I don't mind suing nobody. I don't mind suing Miami police. That's why he's shaking his head. He over y'all. He's shaking his head. And I'm on camera at the airport. This illegal as fuck. I have a ticket. And y'all mad because I have literally... The plate got stopped because I have a ticket to go.
I'll get you. What do you need?
She goes to jail for that.
Yeah. Once you refuse to get off the airplane, that's trespassing.
Get me the info.
I will. Down
the stairs.
'Cause you're under arrest. Los agentes la esposaron mientras ella pedía a todos que encendieran las cámaras y grabaran, pero todo fue en vano. Luego, la escoltaron hasta el estacionamiento del aeropuerto y la llevaron a la cárcel. Posteriormente, la mujer enfrentó una serie de cargos, incluida alteración del orden público y destrucción de aeronaves, de modo que fue sentenciada a libertad condicional. Después de la tumultuosa escena en el aeropuerto con esta mujer rebelde, centrémonos en otro incidente que involucra el colapso extremo de otra mujer enojada mientras intenta facturar un equipaje grande. Nuestro tercer incidente ocurrió en la terminal de JetBlue e involucró a Lisa Michelle Landy, quien provocó el caos en lo que parecía un proceso de embarque de rutina. La noche del 1 de julio de 2022, agentes del departamento del sheriff del condado de Broward fueron llamados a una terminal de JetBlue para abordar una situación poco convencional que involucraba a Landy y su equipaje.
Clothing, but heavy.
No tag. I mean, there's a holder, no.
Huh? Yeah, a just folder?
No, no, I'm just saying there's a holder, but no,
right, no,
no name. No. Oh, just looks like clothing.
That heavy?
It's a lot.
No, no,
maybe it was some homeless person.
There's more than just clothing.
It's all underneath.
Yeah, well, not that I want.
Yeah, you don't want to look in there.
But it's like...
You don't want to look with no gloves on and...
Yeah, no, for sure.
Yeah. But on top, it's all clothing.
Yeah, so
there's something heavy, like, underneath the clothing, because there's no way.
This is...
There's no way that's just clothing.
How much it weighs? Do you have a scale?
There's one right here. It should be right there.
Because this is insane.
£78. What could be in there?
Well, that's what I'm saying. It's more than just clothes. It has to be. It's like having an engine or a piece of motor.
It looks like equipment.
Yeah.
It feels like equipment.
Yeah.
No way. I'm just curious. That's just.
No, because.
I just look.
You know, hazardous reasons or. I mean, for me. I mean, I know it's at the JetBlue.
So, yeah, I mean, the dog didn't alert, so at least it's not.
Right, right.
It's nothing dangerous, right, right. Yeah.
This is like. It's as if someone says, hey, you know what, if you guys, we can't retake it.
Oh, it looks like a homeless person's, like, house. I mean, it's got, like, all this, it's all shoes, and whatever the heck, this is like a whole container of Q-tips. This looks like
A la llegada del oficial, inicialmente sospecharon que había equipaje abandonado, sin saber que su dueño había perdido su vuelo. Los oficiales inspeccionaron la bolsa y descubrieron una extraña variedad que incluía documentos de zapatos e incluso un contenedor completo de hisopos.
This looks like documents.
Yeah.
Like
education.
Oh yeah, that's part of what's causing the bump a little bit. Lisa Michelle Landy. She's got a master's degree from Notre Dame. It's pretty good.
We need to find her.
I'm not sure why she would leave a whole suitcase. 561-923-52. Like toiletries too, like hygiene products, like perfume bottles, glass. That's what makes it ridiculously heavy. 83 pounds. Like, what do you have in here? A small child.
And it was... Why would you leave it?
Los oficiales descubrieron el contenido inesperado de la maleta entre las pertenencias. Encontraron un certificado de maestría de Notre Dame que indicaba que Lisa Michelle Landy, la dueña de la maleta, era una educadora. Más tarde, los oficiales encontraron frascos de perfume, vidrio y objetos pesados, lo que generó dudas sobre su contenido. La maleta de una libra presentó un rompecabezas que la policía estaba decidida a resolver.
Border plane either, or attempt to border plane either intoxicated or under the influence. I mean,
it's
could,
crazy.
Well, under the influence, you could, I mean,
smell it.
Oh my goodness. Some of it is so strong. I'm like, oh.
Yeah, like, oh yeah. Yo, lady, we don't speak that here. What are you saying? Are you fucking kidding me? In the airport? In public? You said the N-word? Are you serious? You're yelling that shit here,
Tras la investigación, los oficiales descubrieron que Lisa Michelle Landy había perdido su vuelo y le dijeron que esperara al siguiente. La situación tomó un giro inesperado cuando Landy, ebria y poco cooperativa, llegó al lugar.
No, go. No, you're, yeah, you're gonna go. No, you're gonna take your big ass fucking
cancer.
Get that fucking 83-pound suitcase. Excuse you, that's your shit. Go get it. Get downstairs, lady. Get downstairs.
I can't carry it.
No, get your shit. Go downstairs. Go. Excuse you. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do?
Get your hands.
You're gonna get arrested. That's what. Excuse you.
Just stop.
No. Stop. No.
I want to see my
you're
mother tomorrow.
No. You're arrested now.
He told me. No,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no.
El comportamiento de Landy se volvió cada vez más errático. Al tratar de mantener el orden, los oficiales le pidieron que recuperara su bolso y bajara las escaleras. Landy no cumplió, usó insultos raciales y golpeó al oficial causando una escena en el aeropuerto.
Put your hands behind your back. No. Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back.
It's not up to me. You're the one who's throwing his
phone. Excuse you. Put your hands behind your back.
Stop.
You need
to
stop.
Mother. You're too young, so you don't
No, I am not.
What is
You're acting like a freaking lunatic.
Late 80s, dying of cancer.
Nobody cares right now because you're acting like a lunatic at an airport. You're
I didn't do anything.
You're
wrong.
Shouting racist, derogatory terms in the middle of an airport.
My mom is dying of cancer.
No. You're not when you're blasted drunk, lady.
No, but this officer told me that tomorrow I can.
Well, that was
well not before you started
no, you're the
yelling.
One that
you know what
that
you just said?
You're
you, no.
You're a fucking. Get your
Stop moving
then. You're so fucking manhandling me. $1,400, $1,500 in cash right there.
Okay.
I want it back. My husband is a MedMal attorney. He's a senior partner in Midtown Manhattan.
That's fine.
And there's no way you're going to let that go. I just said.
All right, sit back in the car.
Ow!
Sit down.
Ow! Are you f***ing crazy?
All right, ma'am. We're not playing that game with you acting like a child, all right? You can sit like that. Do what you gotta do.
Landy fue arrestada y luego comenzó a agregar un toque emocional a su arresto, diciendo que necesitaba ver a su madre y a sus dos hijos mañana. Sin embargo, los oficiales no prestaron atención y al final la llevaron al auto de custodia de todas maneras. La mujer fue cargada con una serie de cargos, incluyendo asalto a un oficial e intoxicación pública. Además, fue expulsada de JetBlue Airlines de por vida y sentenciada a libertad condicional y servicio comunitario. Dejando atrás el caos de Landy, prepárate para un cambio rápido al Aeropuerto Internacional de Tampa, donde las travesuras de un hombre borracho de Florida dan un nuevo giro a nuestras aventuras de cuentos de aeropuerto.
Put your hand behind your back.
Wait, let's take this off.
Are you kidding me?
No. We've given you...
This is really happening.
Nuestro cuarto incidente involucra a un hombre borracho cuyo comportamiento rebelde hizo que lo expulsaran de un vuelo en el Aeropuerto Internacional de Tampa. El incidente se desarrolló el 4 de noviembre de 2022, donde las imágenes de la cámara corporal capturan un encuentro bastante tumultuoso que involucra a este presunto borracho.
What's going to happen is you're going to leave the airside,
sure,
and then you go down the ticket booth.
Sure.
We'll get a rebooked right now.
You want to get rebooked or no?
No, I need to be on the first. Concentrate for a second. You're not going on the air. Do you want to be rebooked? Yes or no? Look at me. Yes or no? Do you want to be rebooked? You can't be on this plane. I'm going to ask you one more time. Do you want to be rebooked or no? Okay, let's go. So you want a refund?
We'll refund it.
Sir, you're no longer a ticketed passenger. You have to be off this airside.
Why are we doing this?
We're going to refund it.
No, why are we doing this, guys? I'm
gotta walk that way.
Does he need to sign anything or anything? Okay, come on. You're going to get a refund. You're going to go. Put your arms down, sir.
No.
Walk on your own behalf.
You have to leave.
So my dad has bladder cancer. They will not let me on the plane.
I'm sorry to hear that, but you can't go on the plane.
No. My dad has bladder cancer. He's at Mayo. And you are not letting me on this plane. This is kind of fucked up, man. I gotta say.
They asked you if you wanted to be rebooked. You said no. Keep moving, keep walking.
No, you gotta keep going, you gotta leave.
Why are we doing
because
this?
Because that
guys?
Company's not letting you fly.
No, guys.
And when they tell you
to leave.
Hey,
guys.
You gotta go.
No,
we'll talk, you can talk and walk.
You're not being reasonable right now. Just
yep,
walk.
Talk and walk.
Yeah.
We're just gonna get you out of here.
Just push me out, just push me out.
No, I'm pushing you out.
Cuando los oficiales se acercaron al presunto borracho, él estaba visiblemente molesto con una tensión palpable. Los agentes se comunicaron con el sospechoso instándolo a cooperar y abandonar las instalaciones pacíficamente. Sin embargo, el tipo no pareció cooperar y pudo haber estado bajo la influencia de alcohol.
You gotta keep going. You gotta leave.
Why are we doing
this, guys? Because that company's not letting you fly.
No, guys.
And when they tell you to leave.
Hey, guys.
You gotta go.
We'll
talk. You can talk and walk.
You're not being reasonable right now.
Yep, talk and walk.
Yeah.
We're just gonna get you out of here.
Just push me out. Just push me out.
No, pushing you out. You gotta leave.
And honestly, my dad has quite a
chance. No, we understand that, but you can't fly today.
Just clear it up. Why can't I not fly?
They're not, because that airline said you couldn't.
Pay attention.
Oh, what am I doing? I can cross you. Like,
we don't want you to fall.
However you want.
No. Get off me, man.
All right, listen.
In a second, you're going to go to jail.
Yeah.
So just calm down.
Just relax.
Leave the airside and go out with your life. No, but we're going to walk. No. Can I talk to you? Yes.
You can talk while you walk.
Can I just talk to you?
Walk in that direction. Walk in that direction.
Try to walk.
Listen, keep walking. We're trying not to put you in jail. We're trying to get you out of here.
Jesus Christ, man.
You gotta go.
Threw my shoe off.
Put your shoe on.
Guys, what are you doing? Buddy, you're drunk and they won't let you
fly. No. Can I throw my shit over here?
I look like a fucking asshole. Like, what is happening?
You gotta leave. It's as simple as that. Listen, don't pull your arm away from me again.
No.
Do not pull your arm away from me again. Let me have your
arm. What am I supposed to do, man?
You wanna put your shoe on? I'll let you put your shoe on, but don't pull away.
This is ridiculous, guys.
Listen, you created it. They won't let you fly.
I did not create it.
Yes, you did. Yeah, you did.
You're probably a reasonable guy. We're not intoxicated, but you're
right. Right now, you're not being right.
This is me.
You got to be a responsible adult, right?
You're sure.
Right now, we're gonna get off the Sarasota.
Can I please?
What do you want to do?
Can I please?
Sir, hold on. He can stick that back in there. Stick it back through. So you get your shoe on.
Guys, I swear on my life, man.
Listen, they're not going to let you fly, so you have to leave. We're trying to get you out of here without going to jail. So try to trust us on this.
What do I do?
It doesn't matter. Put your shoe on.
What do I do, though?
You're intoxicated. They won't let you bar. They won't. Put your shoe on. There you go.
Grab your stuff.
Guys, grab your stuff.
What did I do?
Listen, we're going to go without your stuff. We'll grab your stuff. Get your stuff.
Mientras los oficiales lo empujaban hacia la salida, las palabras del hombre se derramaron. Su súplica de compasión resonó mientras hablaba de la batalla de su padre contra el cáncer. A pesar de esto, el tipo borracho estaba atrapado en un círculo de preguntas y la persistencia del oficial le recordaba su intoxicación. La aerolínea le negó volar, así que la meta era simple: una estrategia de salida limpia, esposas y los fríos confines de una celda de prisión.
Train's gonna move. Sit down.
What do I do?
Hold on. First of all, you're not even listening to me. I'm asking you to sit down. That's what I'm asking you to do, and you're not even listening to that.
Well, what am I doing wrong?
You've been drinking.
You're trespassing.
You're intoxicated.
You're trespassing.
I get in under your head. I can smell the alcohol in your breath.
Oh, I get drank.
Just back up.
Holy United will not let you fly.
They're not gonna let you fly.
You're no longer a ticketed passenger, so you can't be on the airside. So we're gonna make sure you get off at the main terminal. If you need help to get to your party, to get you home or get to a cab, we'll help you out with that. If you try to go back on the airside, you will, be arrested for trespass after warning. Do you understand that? I need to yes or no. Yes or no, do you understand
that? What am I doing wrong?
If you try to go back to that airside, you will go to jail.
You trespass. Simple as that.
Guys, what am I doing wrong?
They're a private company.
The craziest shit I've ever seen in my life. You can only go out there if you're flying.
They won't let you fly.
So, all right, here we go. We're gonna go right out this door right here.
This way, man.
Come on. It's a timed door, so we gotta go.
No way.
10-4. Can you break and come
in?
You need
help?
Can you get your
ride? You need help to get
to the
right.
Well, you gotta leave, man. Do you understand? We have two options here. We either escort you off or we take you to jail. We don't want to do the other option, but
you're not helping us. Listen, you're not going to go very far. You're getting ready to go to jail. So stop being. You're intoxicated.
Tell me.
Sir, go ahead. No, we're going that way. Go that way.
No, I'm good here.
No, you're not. You're going.
No. I'm good here.
10:15. Put your hand behind your back.
Wait. Let's take this off.
Are you kidding me?
No. We've given you.
This is really happening.
Yep.
Holy.
Yep. You're going to jail.
This is really happening.
Where's your ID at?
El comportamiento rebelde del hombre borracho le llevó a su arresto. Los oficiales lo esposaron y lo escoltaron hasta el auto de la policía. Sin embargo, extrañamente no se encontraron cargos. Llegados aquí, ¿acaso no has visto este otro incidente? Yo no me lo perdería, ¿eh?